We just switched to 6th Street right now in Austin, Texas as well.
Austin, Texas.
And basically, like, look around here. Like, look at the chaos. How easy would it be to just fall into the frame, like, letting this hectic environment, like, dictate to me how I should feel? If I looked around, I'd be, like, stuck in my head, like, oh, my God, people around, filming, oh, my God. But it's like, no, dictate the fucking rhythm. Okay, it doesn't affect me. Like, you should feel the same right now as if you're in, like, a room isolated by yourself. It's completely irrelevant. Be decisive. Assert your reality. Don't fall into the little permission boy frame of looking around and being a slave to your emotions. Like, look at this. I feel nothing. Being shoved. Girls, guys, people screaming. No kisses. I feel the same.
Being the center of attention isn't bad. And that's what we're conditioned to believe, especially if you're someone who's a bit more of a people pleaser or someone who's introverted. That's what you think, right? I don't want to take up a lot of space. I don't want everyone staring at me. Who am I, right? Who am I to be the center of attention? Others go first because I'm just down here. Pathetic little me. No, 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 no. Okay? And we all have this. Every single person has, you could say, a certain range in which they feel comfortable taking up space. Okay? Taking up space, for example, physically, taking up space emotionally, and taking up space verbally. Okay? Verbally in terms of how much you talk, but also how loud you are. And this here, this range will change depending on the environments that you find yourself in. Okay? You might be, say, with a really close friend of yours, you feel very comfortable with that person, you can take up a lot of space. Right? You feel at ease, you can talk, you can be loud, you don't feel very stifled. Yet, say you go out and you want to meet someone, or you're in a bit more of a high pressure situation, you're surrounded by strangers or people you don't know that well, suddenly that range tightens, right? And you're like, ooh, let me not, you just feel like your body language isn't as relaxed, right? It's kind of like, ooh, no, I'm sorry for existing here. Even emotionally, they just feel it. And even verbally, anyone who talks is like, oh, talk above me. I have nothing to say. Just do it. Yes. And if they ask you to talk, it's very quiet. Okay. I had many experiences like this, especially when I was younger. You know, I had a small group of people that I'd hang out with, or if it was just going out, it's like, oh, you want to talk over me? Right. Or if both people would engage in talking at the same time, I would for sure be the one who would just retract my words, like, and just not talk. Right. It's like, so as I was saying, people experience this now with Zoom, funny enough, right? With Zoom, sometimes two people talk at once and there's always one who just retracts. That was me. I'm like, oh, you want to talk? Way more important than me. You want to go first? Way more important than me. And I would rationalize it and tell myself, this is the polite thing to do. I'm being very polite. I'm letting them go first, right? That's the conditioning that keeps a people pleaser stifled. You want to be polite? Be the center of attention. Now, once more, this probably triggers you, but here's the thing. By you taking responsibility, taking the lead, and basically being, hey, you know what? I'm taking charge here. Look at me. Listen to me. You're actually being very polite because you're allowing others to just take a back seat and enjoy the ride, enjoy the show, and experience you, right? Otherwise, what are you really doing? Think about this, okay? This is a bit of a reversal in terms of how we're conditioned. You think, oh, you go first, you go first. You could also interpret that as you being very impolite. You saying, hey, do it. Entertain me. Oh, I have nothing to say. You talk. Talk for me. That's a little impolite. What about going first? Like, hey, no. You know what? You sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. When it comes to being the center of attention, the next big block is, well, I don't really know what to say, right? Number one, who am I to take up space? Number two, do I have anything valuable to say that's worthy of being the center of attention, right? If I'm going to tell everyone, hey, attention on me, what am I going to say? And with this here, this is also very counterintuitive. You have to lower the bar. Realize this. Cool people, people of high value, people who assume that everyone is on their side, all is good, they're in a very collaborative state, their bar for how good what they have to say actually is very low. People who are low value, people who are trying to impress, their bar is very high. If you want to be high value, if you want to be the person at the center of the room, the center of attention, who everyone's like, ooh, who's that? You can't do it with a bar so high. You have to purposely lower the bar. Now, what do I mean by having a high bar or a low bar? Okay, realize that Whenever you're talking to someone, or you're in an interaction, or you're surrounded with a lot of people, there's a filter. Okay, we all have this filter, and you could say this is a bar. And with everything that comes through your mind, you're like, ooh, is this good enough to say, yes or no? And if the bar is very high, it's like, not good enough. What about this? Not good enough. Oh, this is good enough. And you say that. And this is why it can be very hard or choppy when it comes to talking to people you believe are outside your league, right? When there's a lot of social pressure, like, oh, who am I? I must really impress. The bar gets so high that in your mind, sometimes nothing is good enough. And this is when people run out of things to say. Instead, lower the bar. Hey, this is good enough. Say it. Again, you're not there to impress. You're not this try-hard person, because think about it too. Say you master it and everything you say is just perfect. It just comes off as try-hard, right? Lower the bar. Whatever I have to say is good enough just because. The next thing is you want to learn to feel comfortable with massive amounts of social pressure, because that's the next thing, right? Okay, I'm good enough. What I have to say is good enough. And then you do it and then people actually stare. All eyes are on you, and the people are like, oh, too much pressure, and then they shy away. And that's just terrible, okay? Everyone, this is very key, everyone wants to be cool, yet they want to be cool without the social pressure that comes with being cool. Everyone wants to be the main person, the high value, high status person, yet they don't want the social pressure that comes with that. Guess what? Social pressure comes with the territory of being cool. You can't be the main person. You can't have all eyes on you without social pressure. You have a friend, and have your friend say in front of you right now, and you're going to give yourself a certain amount of time. Right? It could be like, okay, for 1 minute, I'm just going to talk about a certain topic. It could be like your favorite movie. I'm going to talk about my favorite movie. And during that time, your friend for that 1 minute is going to distract you. So the entire time you're like, so my favorite movie is blah, blah, blah. And you're going to talk about what you like about the movie. And the entire time your friend's going to be talking back, clapping in your face, doing whatnot, just anything to distract you. And your job is not to lose your train of thought and to just keep talking about the movie as if no one's there. Okay, this will really get you in the habit of distractions, people staring, and just drawing state from within, keeping your cool and not getting shoved in your head, or just being so dependent on the external, okay? It'll also trigger a lot with it, once more, that you can let go of. One of you is gonna go first for a minute. And you're gonna talk about your pen. And I want you to make it captivating. I want you to start bringing your awareness to all this. And while you're doing so, talking about your pen, the person facing you is going to distract you. So for example, you're talking about the pen, they could clap in your face, they could say stuff, they could ask you questions, they're gonna try to shove you in your head, and your job is to not get shoved in your head, okay? For example, okay, let's just do it. Stand up for a second, okay? Talk about your pen. 3, 2, 1, go.
Oh, I really love this pen.
Why are you doing that with your hand, by the way? Really? Why can't you look at me in the eyes? Why are you getting so nervous coming in? Look, you already ran out of things to say. Why are you laughing? You think it's gonna help? Why are you quiet? Look, Why are you? You're literally trembling in front of everyone. You should check it out. But why are you doing this? Dude, you trying to touch your dick or something? What now? Now you're in your head? Why are you in your head? Dude, you keep like, it's so weird. It's the worst presentation I've seen ever. Dude, what is it? You think it's gonna help waving it in my face? Look, it makes no sense. Like, look, now you're already reacting to me. You're in your head. It's done. You're blinking. You're quiet. You lost your train of thought. I'm controlling you. I'm in control of you right now. I'm controlling. I'm pulling the strings. Look, yeah, move it like this. Now move it up. Move it up. Yeah, react to me some more. Touch me. Yeah, move it down now. Yeah, smile. Smile. I'm controlling you. I'm controlling you. Yeah, bring it in. Bring it in. Okay, so that is what I want you to do. Now notice, okay, one of the ways, I do it, and this can be very effective, it's called pacing and leading. Do you know this, pacing and leading? So what did I do for him, okay? Whoop, let me reattach that. Pacing and leading. Say right now, I'm like, okay, why are you touching the cap? Keep touching it. Now you're smiling. Now you're looking at me. Now you're smiling some more. Yeah, move it again. Yep, look, think of the crowd. Hear the laugh, smile again. You totally know I'm pacing and leading. Now I'm leading you. Now your eyebrows are shifting. I'm in control. Pacing, leading. You describe what they do at first. Why are you nervously touching it? Yeah, now you look at me. Look at him.
Now you're thinking, damn, he's doing it to me. Now you're looking up. Now you're reacting. Now I'm in control. And now you're nervous. Now you're in your head, looking up, trying to pretend it's not there, smiling, hoping it's going to end. When is he going to end? I know what you're thinking. I'm in control. Pacing, leading. What about you? Why are you caressing it? Think it's your dick? Now you're thinking, oh man, I'm going to try to be unreactive. I'm not going to do anything. He won't be able to pace and lead, but I can pace and lead your thoughts. I know exactly what you're thinking. Getting nervous? Yep. Sweating, looking up. Now I'm touching your hand. Now you're caressing yourself. Dude, what's wrong with you? Why are you caressing yourself? Why are you not moving? Are you a robot? Are you dead inside? You have no soul? Trying to be unreactive? Pace, lead. Pace, lead. So it's like, start by first describing, and then you can go get one step ahead. And then you're doing this. And then you're doing that. And they're like, oh. And if someone's saying that to you while you're trying to talk about the pen, you'll feel that pull. You'll feel the pressure. Like, oh my God. And it's like, no. Remain grounded. Remain grounded. Remain grounded. Draw from within. Okay, and it'll also show you just how much you are pinging off the environment, how much you are depending on the environment, how much of your confidence is situational. You were saying in different situations, like with your close friends, it's a blast. Other friends are like, it's different, because you're drawing it externally. This here, it'll show you, like, no, draw it from within. If you build this muscle, and this is the external approach, okay, the internal is letting go, but if you build this, no matter where you're at, just draw it from within. People could be smiling, people could be like, draw it from within, not affected. I'm in control of my state. I'm in control of what I say. I'm my own point of orientation, not others. So for 1 minute, and this one's fun on both sides, by the way.
What do you do when someone pays you? It's like,
remain grounded.
But you don't answer, you don't respond to the person?
Keep talking about the pen. That's your mission. Your mission is to keep talking about the pen, not get shoved in your head, not react, to keep generating from within. Okay, decide who goes first for 1 minute. Okay, 3, 2, 1, go.
This one here, I would do it, by the way, with friends back in the day for like 15 minutes straight. For 15 minutes, we'd keep on going, trying to distract one another and just seeing who could go the longest without getting shoved in their head. The next one, and this is really the big one, it's letting go of attaching your self-worth to what people think of you, right? Is this good enough? Their approval, that matters, right? Oh, other people first. It's like, no, no, no. Of course I'm going to be respectful. Of course I'm going to be aware. Of course I'm going to be calibrated and relatable, but no one's opinion of me raises or decreases my self-worth. And this is why letting go is really the foundation when it comes to socializing, when it comes to social skills, right? People sometimes say, like, oh, but this letting go, talk about social skills. I'm like, hey, this is social skills. If you don't see how letting go really covers 80% of social skills, you're crazy.
Like, this program is such a game changer. The way everything's structured and the material, it's been already, even for me, it's just been, I'm noticing a crazy change in the way that my whole life's like playing out.
What you put together is just incredible. There's nothing like that.
I've just jumped like a million levels. It's just been a complete 180 for my experience of existing. That's awesome.
It's just been so huge in terms of so many of the things I'm finally understanding and realizing and epiphanies I'm having.
What you do is a huge inspiration to me, and I think it's one of the most beautiful things you can give to another human in this entire world.
You save my fucking life, man. I'm telling you, this is
sometimes all it takes is just one person who believes in you. Find people who are where you are in life and model them, work with them. I would not be here if I didn't have people who held me accountable.
Wow.
I just felt a click and things are changing.
This program was just top notch.
Seriously, like, this is a masterpiece. This is perfect.
Everything, the way it's set up, the live calls, like all the support from the coaches is incredible.
It's been nuts. I just had my tears of joy.
This was the best decisions I ever made.
Thank you for creating something wonderful like this.
This program was phenomenal.
This program was amazing.
This program has definitely changed my life.
I know for a fact I'm in the right place.
This is exactly what I was expecting from the program.
It's been spectacular.
I feel really lucky to have found you.
Thank you so much, Julian. It's worth every dollar.